Well, this year's Queen's Birthday list has recognised quiet achievers to rock stars. Iva Davies honoured his country through song, and today it honoured him in return. We'll chat with Iva Davies in a moment, but first Jessica Turner reports on some of the other outstanding Australians who've made the list this year.
The Queen's birthday is a chance to say thanks for gifts great Australians have given us. Bruce and Denise Morecambe, whose tragedy has touched us all, are among those being honoured. Their son Daniel was abducted and killed, but they're using their loss to help others, teaching children about safety.
The uniqueness that we bring to the table is linking Daniel's very real story back to those safety messages.
Andrew Downey doesn't share stories.
Has it happened before?
But instead has been listening to them since 1971 as a telephone counsellor at Lifeline.
It is nice that that volunteers get recognised as well as people who are more prominent in society, I guess.
He's talking about sports stars like Tour de France winner Cadel Evans and Casey Stoner for his service to motorcycle racing. Simone McMahon is giving a different kind of gift. She was born with just one kidney.
That a complete stranger gave that gift to me to change my life so much, you know, and I think that was sort of the motivating factor, I guess, that set me up on my mission.
She's now set up an organ donation organisation, giving hope to almost 1,700 other Australians still waiting for a transplant. Among the top honours, law academic James Crawford and author Jill Kerr Conway for her contribution to the community, especially women. Former St Kilda player Ross Oakley sees his award as an endorsement not only of him, but his family. He oversaw the transition of the VFL to the AFL and has learnt a few things about people along the way.
It's the positive people that you've got to really promote and look for, because that's where things will get done.
All positive people, all positively deserving.
Jessica Turner with that report. Well, the Icehouse frontman, Iva Davies, is one of those that was recognised in the honours today. He's here with us this evening. You're a member of the Order of Australia. I know you don't do the work to get these types of recognition, but it must feel wonderful to be recognised in this way.
It is, and it's a reflection of the fact that I've been incredibly lucky with my career, but also my career and the profile that's built has allowed me to be able to help other people and work for charities and so on, and that's something I do a great deal of.
I mean, everyone will know you for Great Southern Land, and I do want to ask you about that, but this award is for all of your charity work, but also your music work in other realms that I think many people will not be familiar with.
Well, as I was growing up, I was classically trained. I intended being a professional oboist. I was a professional oboist. But that training enabled me later down the line to do things like write ballets and film scores, and I'm eternally grateful for my teachers for having got that good grounding.
So many people today enter the sort of popular music industry without classical backgrounds. Do you think that helped you?
Oh, enormously, enormously. I think probably the single biggest advantage was having that knowledge. It just makes everything that much more efficient. It's quicker. It's a strange thing to say, but it just makes it work faster.
We can hear a bit of Great Southern Land there. I read you saying that you were surprised, and you're still surprised, at the impact that that had. Why? I mean, it is something that we all know and love, and would seem so obvious that it would have that reaction.
Well, it was... I knew it was a difficult thing to take on, and it's a very uncharacteristic of me anyway. I'm a very conservative person. I knew if I got it wrong that it would blow up in my face. I thought I'd done a decent job, but the way that people reacted was, you know, quite immediate and disproportionate. And I've been grateful ever since, of course, but it's incredible to be talking about it 31 years down the line.
When it first happened and it first went big, was it a sense of surprise or a sense of, I don't know, what I've gotten myself into?
I think if you place it in history, it was the first single to come out after an incredibly successful debut album. So it was that difficult second album, and this was the lead song from it. And so I was absolutely terrified it'd be a failure. Mm.
The thing that success led you to was the ability to be a spokesperson, to be involved in charity, and you've done a huge amount of that work, and that's also why you're being recognised. Can you compare, reflect on what contribution you feel has been most valuable?
Well, you know, I don't know whether... I don't look at it in terms of my contribution necessarily. It it's incredibly good for me. It's incredibly life-affirming to work with people who are so inspiring and passionate and generous with their time. I really look forward to a lot of the events that I attend because I get to be with those people. They are truly inspiring.
Presumably, though, when you go into the music business, you don't do it imagining that you're going to have this big impact on all sorts of charities and causes that perhaps previously you had nothing to do with. So that must be at least surprising.
Well, it's one thing leads to another. It's interesting when you start doing that kind of work, doors open, people know it. There's a whole community of people, and it really is the case that there are wonderful people out there, and loads of them, who will never get this kind of recognition, and I guess I take on this on their behalf.
Iva Davies, we'll leave it there. Congratulations. I don't know if I can believe that you're conservative when you've got the hair and the bright green shirt, but congratulations anyway. It was great to meet you.
Thank you very much.